There is a word called romance, and it's when there is a affection and love and excitement and a sense of mystery that partners would have one with another. And normally they're not married, but married people can romance each other. And, you know, they've taken that term to put to bromance, foodmance. You know, any situation where you have a strong affection, you look forward to seeing someone, you make dates, you're excited, it's just not something just willy-nilly, but you're planning, you're looking forward to that, being around that person, there's some anticipation, you know, romance. And again, it's been used in many other places like bromance and foodmance. But what about a Godmance? What about a Yahweh manse, where we have our affection towards our Father to the extent that we are just always thinking about how we could please Him, how we, you know, getting together with our Father and the privilege that we have now because of what Jesus Christ did on the cross, to have this intimate relationship with Him all the time, and we can all the time talk love talk to our God and say, Yahweh, Yahweh, you are awesome in this place. We can say, you are stupendous, you are wonderful, you are glorious, you are powerful. You know, we can just Godmance our Father and say wonderful things because He's such a wonderful God. But what if our romance of God is to love the things that He loves, so that in our forgiving people, we don't even want to forgive, we don't want to think about it, we won't be done with. But in our forgiving, it's a way like, I'm romancing God in my forgiving. And what about in your giving? And I'm not talking ritualistic giving, but what the Word of God says we should be doing as the Kingdom of God people, and evangelizing, like He says, if you love me, feed my sheep. And so we're flirting with God, getting God's attention when we are telling people about how awesome our God is, because we're so in love with Him that in our living, we are moving and sharing the gospel of Christ and giving people an opportunity to love on our God too. So I'll be loving God in my forgiving. I'll be loving God in my living when I wake up and say, new mercies every day. Wow. So I'm loving on God because I'm excited about, and I know that this is the day the Lord has made and I will rejoice in it. I'm rejoicing in it because I'm loving on God, because when Jesus died on the cross, He said, it's finished. He is my all in all. I have shalom, nothing missing, nothing broken and I'm the object of His affection, that He loves me with an everlasting love, that He will never leave me nor forsake me. So in my forgiving, in my giving, and in my day-to-day living, I can be romancing God by my response to it. That's why I was singing, I'll be loving you, I'll be loving you, I'll be loving you, my forgiving. I'll be loving you, I'll be loving you in my living. I'll be loving you, I'll be loving you in my living. I'll be loving you. He says, whatever we do in word or deed, do it in the name of Jesus and do it in love. So if what I'm doing is to show glory to God, my love to God, my faithfulness to God, then I'll be loving. And the great thing about this is the love that I'm loving God with is His love. The life that I'm living for God, it's the life He gives. And everything He gives me is everything I have an opportunity to give in what terms of gifts and talents He gives me. And the forgiveness that he mandates that I give, it's not optional. I get blessed because of it. I get greater liberty and an opportunity to show my love to others and my love to God. Wow. It's a wonderful thing as we begin to understand the depth, the breadth, the height, and the length of the love of God that passes all understanding. I pray that we continue to grow into understanding that love that conquers all, believes all, hopes all, that casts out all fear, that causes all things, the impossible, to be made possible, because God is love. And the Holy Spirit has shed abroad love in our heart, abroad love in our heart by the Holy Ghost. And that love causes faith to work, and that pleases God. So like it comes like full circle. It's all good. It's all God. And it's all about love. So if you deal with the crucifixion and the resurrection and you forget that it was all about love, you've missed it.